Over 46 million people suffer from arthritis. Musculoskeletal conditions account for as many as 92 million doctor's office visits. Pain caused by arthritis or injury is typically treated with joint injections. According to orthopedic studies, 70% of joint injections delivered to the knee and shoulder regions fail to reach their target. An orthopedic surgeon, Dr. Ed Bartlett, in partnership with engineering faculty and students at East Carolina University, envisioned a new type of syringe which will help doctors use flow impedance to identify the appropriate location for orthopedic injections such as cortisone shots. Dr. Bartlett's device will ensure proper placement and delivery of such injections.
The concept of what we're trying to do probably might not occur to an engineer that hasn't been doing injections for 25 years. But the fellow that has the concept in no way can transfer that into the electrical technology of force sensors and displacement sensors and software programs. Now what we're going to do today, since we're trying to demonstrate the difference, is that we're going to actually inject into a tendon first, where we're going to have a high resistance or impedance to our device, and then we're going to go for the joint. The software has allowed us to make a determination of when we have an easy enough flow that we're in the joint, and should give us a green light when we're ready to go. If we're in the tendon, we should get the red light. So to test this device, Clint, let's start out by going into an area we know we don't want to go into, which is going to be the distal quadriceps tendon. If you'll aim right for the top pole of the patella, down into the tendon, where you meet that resistance, it's kind of deep there. You feel like you're in the middle of the tendon. All right, now just press and try and deliver the fluid. So now let's reorient, since that was going directly into the patella, and let's go into the joint space. And now you should have a tactile sense of less resistance when you try and press on that. And our software should translate that into less impedance. And that didn't give you as much resistance as when we were injecting sort of into the bone and the tendon there, did it?
The ideal markets for the syringe are medical schools that train doctors to properly deliver joint injections and medical practices or physicians who currently deliver joint injections.
I think the next stage for us is to refine the prototype, try and make it more tissue specific, and build that into the device itself. Hopefully we can find a corporate partner that wants us to help refine this device, make it applicable in the millions of injections that are done in this country every year, and take it to market.